brother-in-law to figure it out. What did I do on Friday? I know exactly what I did on Shabbat. But on Friday night, it's like, it was normal. We ate at home. It was fun. We played two games at night at the dinner. It was, I think, normal house.
Festival. It was like a day that my friends and I waiting for, I think something like 6 months. It was so beautiful and exciting, and there were a lot of colorful people. I think the trans community is really warm community. We like a family, and people came to share love and to dance and to feel at their safest place. And there was a beautiful sunrise, and everything was so pure and happy, and suddenly everything brutally stopped with the pure evil. We start to hear the rockets above us, and all the sky was with a lot of rockets. And at first we didn't feel in danger, because in our life in Israel, it's an ordinary thing. It's sad to say, but we used to hear the bombs, and we used to run away from rockets. And I think we understand there is a danger when we start to hear the gunshot, and we understand there is a terrorist. And I'm not gonna tell all the story, but we tackled by terrorists, and we ran away with car, and we saw a lot of burned cars. I saw people run and felt from the gunshots.
Shabbat morning, my daughter likes to cuddle with us in bed, so she was with us in bed. She was the first one who realized that there was alarm. The beginning we told her that there isn't, because we couldn't hear it after half a second. We heard a whistle. We have the Iron Dome behind my kibbutz. So we hear the whistle of the Iron Dome starting to send a rocket. And then we woke up and we heard their alarm. So I had to take her to the safe room with my husband, but I had two nieces in my house that were hosting my brother and daughters. They were staying in my daughter's room, so I had to run over and wake them up and tell them, let's go to the safe room. We call it Mamad. We have 15 seconds to go to the Mamad. I don't think a lot of you realize that 15 seconds, it's a long time for us in the region where we live. In Tel Aviv, it takes a minute and a half. In Be'er Sheva, it's a minute. In Be'eri, it's also 15 seconds. Because we live close by, I just realized, and I'm sorry, but I have to say, every time when they're sending a missile to our kibbutz, it's about 40,000 people that are getting up and going to the safe room for 15 seconds. Because we have Sderot, my kibbutz is next to Sderot also, and we have also five kibbutzes around. And another small village also. So it's a lot of people that are waking up, just to let you know, every time when they're sending a rocket to our area. We got to the safe room, my son was sleeping, he used to it. So he's 14 years old, and he used to it, so he didn't even wake up. He's sleeping in the safe room, and I had to wake up my second son, Oded, who's 12, and he just went and continued sleeping over there. My husband, in the meantime, took out two mattresses and put them on the floor because it's a small room. We put the two kids over there, the daughters of my brother, and my daughter was also sleeping there, and they started to ask questions, why we need to go to the safe room, why we need to be there. They don't know, they're not from the area. They live in Ramat HaSharon next to Tel Aviv. We wanted them to go to sleep, to tell you the truth. I felt like, don't ask any questions, just go to sleep. My husband explained them that we're in the safe room and everything is okay. Nothing will happen, and there's missiles that are coming from Gaza. And after a minute or so, we got a lot of text messages. I got text messages from my kids also. They started to say that there is a terrorist attack in Sderot. They don't know what to do. And each one of them started to responding and saying, inviting, they're shooting at my door. They're trying to get inside the gate of the house. There was a lot of confusion, I think, in the messages over there. I'm also in charge of the vacuum, also in the kibbutz. So the first thing that I did is I sent to my group of the evacuation group, not again. Are we going to evacuate the kibbutz? And they responded that it's too early to say that we're going to evacuate. It's only a missile. It was 6:30, around 7:30 in the morning. I realized there is also a terrorist group around our kibbutz, because people started to text the shooting in here also, on the houses and everything. I sent a message in the kibbutz and said, there's a terrorist attack, please go inside the safe room and lock everything. This is it, basically. We stayed there for 27 hours in the house.
With it. So this is Ani Gitara.
It's ad lavetach.
וטעויות צבעוניות על כל השטח. אני גיטרה, הרוח מנגן עליי בחילופי עונות. אני גיטרה ומישהו בורט עליי בחילופי המנגינות. מה שנוגע לבנות, יש הסכמים, יש הבנות, ואין לי אין לי טענות, גם לא היו לי. ביוני יולי אני גיטרה, הייתי פעם עץ אולי, ובתיבה התהודה אני זוכרת כל מי שניגן עליי, ואני אומר תודה.